Alrighty, we're gonna take on the very hard Lapaina Coast dungeon, or very crisis dungeon that was just dropped today. And we are gonna take a look at this bad boy. So it looks like we're gonna need to bring fire, obviously, because we have the fire potency. Not only that, but we got Gallon Balor, so there's probably gonna be some good, a good chunk of enemies weak to fire, among other things. I think it's just some auto thing. Okay, so we're gonna go put over this thing. And then I'm going to more or less keep my stuff pretty similar. I'm going to leave Aerith here with what she has. However, I am going to give her a fire element. And I think for Gallon Balor, we want what? Circle? Right? Yeah, we want circle. Yeah, so we're going to want circle. So she's got circle there. And we're going to want to pump a fire in here. Looking for magic attack, we'll take the Fira. Outside of that, everything else is pretty much going to stay the same for Aerith. I just need her to do her job, which is debuff and heal. That's all I need her for. Cloud's going to be a little different. Since we're focusing on fire, we're definitely going to want to have the Flame Blade Arcanum here. We're going to pop that bad boy in. And then we're going to swap this weapon out for... We're going to bring in the... There it is. Sky Splitter for big fire damage. So, and then we will have Masamune over here. That way I can do some electric damage if I need to. So now this is going to switch over to an X sigil. So we're going to want to put that here in case I need it. Let's find our X sigil. There's the good one that we want. Let's grab that one. And then we're going to also want... He's got both now, I guess. And then we're also going to want to put in another... Some kind of other sigil. Big attack. So circle. We're going to need that. And then we have lightning already. So this is great, right? We're going to have multiple elements. So let's go ahead and put one more element in. Let's go do Aurora Blow. It's got big physical attack. It's got some other good stuff. We'll go ahead and punch that in case I need it for something. So actually, let's take a look. Quick Aurora Blow. Yeah, no. That's definitely... Aurora Blow is definitely the way to go. So we'll pop that in. Now for the weapons over here, I think I'm going to have to mostly leave them the same. I could increase damage a tad by putting this in. So it's going to go up, and I'm going to get that physical ability potency because right now I am at 3... But that's not even going to give me enough, I don't think, to boost me to the next level. It will. Okay, so it'll boost me to 4. So I'm going to get an extra 15% attack. But how much is my HP going to drop? No. My damage goes up. My physical defense goes down, but not by a ton. So we go ahead and bring that for extra damage. So that works. Because, again, fire potency, it does a lot of extra. I'm going to go ahead and stick out with Aerith here. And I forgot to change. We're going to go ahead and swap up the summon. So we're going to throw on Hellfire here because all the extra fire damage I'm going to be getting. So we definitely want to maximize that. Aerith, we're going to stick to Healing Wave. That seems like a pretty much a given. And then over here for Tifa, I'm going to stick to more or less the same kind of setup here. I don't really need to change it out too much at all. Let's see here. I know fire potency goes up, but we don't really gain a huge chunk of fire potency. So we'll leave this. Now, water is going to need to come out. We don't really need that. So we want a fire attack. So we got fire blow. And then we're going to want to have a circle of some kind as well. So let's go ahead and find a circle to throw in here. With big physical attack. We'll just do this. There we go. Ruin blow circle. It's got okay physical attack, right? This one's actually better. It's got some healing in it. If I need it, higher physical defense. It's actually a better option here, if I would say so myself. Yeah, we'll take that one. And then, so we got the fire. I don't have any really other elements. Granted, Cloud will have that covered for the most part. Tifa's got the heal if I need it. And then Aerith over here covering with that. And then sub-weapons. We're going to go ahead and move this, I think, out. Or is there any I want? Is there actually any I need to put in for this? Yeah, there's not really any that are worth putting in. Glarade's going to do us a nice good chunk of damage there. I can't see the need for anything else that's really going to give us a big boost that we could use. Actually, that's not true. If we put in this bad boy, we'll get a nice little extra boost to some of our damage. Yeah, because our magic attack is going to jump up quite a bit. So that'll help limit breaks anyway, even though I lose out the limit break boost, but this is going to do overall damage just across the board greater. But we want to take that. That'll pretty much cover us, right? Because again, we got our fire coverage. Everybody's got fire. He's got wind and lightning in case I need it. So that'll give me some extra damage in different elements. And that should cover most things. Here's my sub for Aerith. Got the guard stick because it's going to give us good heals. I could do something different if I want, but if I don't want those heals as well. So if I want to focus on, I don't even know why it's like physical attack, but if I want to focus on magic, I could throw on something like, I could throw on edge wings, but I'm going to lose that healing, right? So I really want to keep that healing going. I want to keep it alive. So that's going to be a pretty big deal there. So I got her with physical attack or physical boost here. Actually, given her magical here might not be a bad idea. Let's go ahead and swap this up. Let's give her something with HP and physical defense. Because that'll help out quite a bit. Oops, we still want to focus on level. I need to go HP here. And there we go. Actually, let's do magic defense. There we go. Because again, she's my healer. I need her alive. So that's kind of important. Yeah, so this one wouldn't be bad. It actually gives me extra healing, but I need that HP, right? That HP is crucial. Without the HP, I'm in hot water. Yeah, so I do get HP there, but not as much as this one. But I gain higher physical defense. Magic defense. Yeah, I think the 1,000 HP is more important. So we'll go ahead and put that there. That way she's got physical defense and everything like that. Cloud's kind of lacking in that front, but I kind of have to sacrifice something there. But he's got a good chunk. Granted, maybe it would be a good idea to actually give him a little bit more HP here, right? I don't think that's a bad idea. So let's go ahead and let's get him some defenses in some way, right? So let's see what we can grab here. Let's take a look. So this one's going to have magic defense, which might be nice. I would like to keep my physical attack up if I can. So some of these wouldn't be too bad. Let's go. Yeah, that's going to give me some big HP. So I think that's the way. Yeah, let's go ahead and take this one here. So that'll give me some good HP. Yeah, Tifa's fine. She's got plenty of HP. Like, all her HP is coming from this bad boy right here. Like, pretty much all right there. So that's good. So now everybody's got good HP. They're over 8,000 at least. So that's going to be a big help. Aerith's got killer heals. Doesn't really need to go any higher than 2,000. That's a good chunk. So I think we're ready to start and take this bad boy on. Yeah, we're good to go. So poison is pretty much my main concern, because poison can just absolutely tear you apart if you don't have a heal for it. So anytime you're going into something like this blind, like I'm doing right now, I always recommend bringing poison, because you never know what you're going to expect and what's going to come across. So, all right, so fire cocktail. We want to try to look for basic enemies up front. Now I see an item here, so I'm going to go ahead and grab that. I'm not going to grab that. I lied. So we want to find some basic enemies that we can maybe grind on, do a little something, something, you know what I mean? Nah, mean? Cool. All right, there's some basic guys here. Now, a good trick, and it wouldn't be too bad, is to sit in defense mode and then just build up, right? And we have all kinds of ways we can build up here. All right, so let's go ahead and do that. We'll try to kill these guys first if we can. So it wouldn't be a bad thing. I keep hitting the wrong button. That's fine. Oh, Cloud was knocked out. I didn't see that. Okay. Yeah, so the reason why I'm doing this is I want to build up meter for the very first fight. These fights aren't timed, so it really doesn't matter how much time you use on these. So you basically just want to sit there on these and just do your thing. Just hang out. Now these guys just aren't taking any damage, and that's okay. That's kind of what we want to do. Build up as much ATB as we can. And you generally want to try to do physical moves. Physical moves will allow you to do more, build up your meter faster. So that's why I'm focusing on those if I can. Yeah, these guys aren't hitting hard right now, so that's perfect. I'm going to go do a party heal there. Work out. There we go. Now Tifa's buff is gone. That's what I wanted to see. So this way, we get to the first fight. We can just pump out some big damage right up front. And that way, too, Aerith will always have a move available, or her limit break available, to just be on hand to heal us as needed. So that'll be useful. Gotta keep this up. So I recommend everybody do this anytime you're gonna do anything. That if you're going in blind and you're like, you're not confident or your power level is going to end up being around what the battle level is, I highly recommend you always do this. There's pretty much almost no reason not to do this. Like, it's just, it's so beneficial, it's insane. There's only positives with this. All right, so we're starting to move. So we want to start trying to kill some of these guys. Yeah, so see how everybody's at limit now? So that's really good. Now we're just going to hang out. I want everybody to build meter. Yeah, more than anything, though, I want Aerith to basically heal us up. So this way Tifa can start the next fight, get a buff in, and then we can go ham. Go ham! So that's the play. Alright, so first fight. Let's go. Okay, so we got the ice boy, and again, this is why I brought the poison. This poison would be very, very bad for me here. I gotta get into physical mode here. Yep, there's the poison, like I said, there, and it's gone. Very important that I did that. I'm gonna go ahead and lower his attack now, just to be on the safe side, it'll help out. And then I'm just gonna go ahead and hit with these two here. We don't need to do any others. There we go. See, some good solid damage right up front. It gets us through these fights much faster. And that's what we need. We need to get through them quick. So we definitely want Cloud dealing as much as we can here. Another poison. We got to get rid of that. And we want to pop him with as much damage as we can right now. Just get him out of here ASAP, right? We're almost there. All right, this will take him out. Goodbye, sir. There it is. Yeah, so this is why I always bring poison. If I didn't have if poison Isuna, I would have been cooked. I would have taken so much damage. This would not have been that score that it was. I'd have to spend a lot of time healing. You don't want that. You don't want that. It's really bad. Bad for business. Perfect. Okay, so we got fire potency up here, physical defense drop. Fire potency is nice, but I don't think it's worth having the defense drops, right? If it was equal or maybe a little bit less, sure. But it's too risky. I'm gonna go ahead and grab an item here. We're gonna see if there's any enemies we can run into. Okay, so that is a single enemy. That's a three pack. Okay, so we want to see if we can find. A three-pack wouldn't be bad to hit here just to get rid of them. And am I almost at my limit break? Aerith is. Cloud is getting there. I mean, because if I cross this, I can't take on that three-pack. Yeah, let's cross it. Let's cross it. I think that's the play. We might run into an enemy here. All right, we got a three-pack anyway. So I would like to actually run into an enemy if there is one here. There is not. Okay. But we have confirmed no enemy at this spot. So again, take out the adds. The two little guys first. Those are going to be priority number one. Oh yeah, definitely want to take these guys out first. So we're going to want to pop them with Aerith if I can real quick. And then Tifa, I'm actually going to want her to do some of these extras, to do some, get some damage down. See that right there? Very important we do that. Yeah, sure, we'll take that heal. Yeah, lowering his physical attack was really important. Okay, now we need to get rid of this guy. There we go, he's almost dead. Okay, now he is dead. Royal stance, okay. Pretty much almost there. And good night, sir. Let's get a heal here from Aerith. Might as well, that's worth it. And yeah, now we just pummel him, right? Nothing to it but to do it. Just pummel him. Oh yeah, this guy's getting cooked. Yeah, I was gonna say one shot and he's probably dead, so I figured I'd just wait that out. So now having Hellfire on the next fight is gonna be very, very useful. So again, bringing that physical attack down, really useful for this. Because that's the hag in there, man. If he gets really strong, you're gonna get cooked. Now this is a scenario because we only have, well, we still have one guy up there, huh? Yeah, okay, so I'm probably gonna go ahead and we're gonna grab the physical attack up versus magic attack down because our main damage is coming from physical attackers, right? So what I'm gonna do here is we wanna take on this one ASAP because I don't wanna run into any enemies and I wanna pop my limit breaks like stat, you know? So I wanna get my buffs out. I wanna focus on the middle guy and then pop my limit breaks. So we're gonna do this. We're gonna get some stats down and then we also need to get No Mercy up. And then we'll have some big damage. Much as I can. Oh, he stunned me. That's rude. Okay, we'll just have Aerith do a heal there. It doesn't hurt. Perfect. Oh, he lowered my magic attack. That's rude. Yeah, so that's why I do that. See how we take out the guys on the side? The guy in the middle is just getting cooked now. Easy choice. Fight's already almost done. Look at that. 300k. Yeah, this will probably kill. Yep, there it is. So that's why I went for that fight, because I knew I needed to use that Hellfire right away. Because there's probably another little enemy we can fight somewhere right around here. Let's see if we can find that guy. All right, so again, we're going to want to go with physical attack up, so just keep with that physical attack. There's probably a regular enemy over here somewhere. Oh, okay, that's where the finishing boss is. So that's good. I thought maybe it was higher further up, but it's not. So again, we're going to do the same concept here. We want to build up meter. Actually, we don't want to build up meter too much. In fact, I lied, because if I go too much, then I'm going to end up having the issue where on the following fight, I want to actually be strong up front. I want to be a little bit strong. I'd like this guy to put on a defensive boost if he could. Okay. I want to gain as much meter as I could there with Cloud. Alright, so we already know that's a Gallon Balor. We're aware of that fight. Cottage? Okay, that's nice. And let's go. This is gonna probably be the last one up here. There might be something past this guy. So it's a single target. Could use some ATB, but I think we're all right. Just want to make sure we're starting off. We don't want to attack yet until we get to that full meter. Our attack damage is gonna go through the roof once we do. All right. So Aerith can go ahead and do whatever she wants. She's not dishing out a ton of damage. So as soon as she starts off with those debuffs, that's what we want to see. This guy is primarily magic damage, so Fog Breath is perfect because she doesn't do any fog baloney. And then we just kind of keep up the damage. Oh man, this guy's just gonna get cooked. In fact, yeah, this guy is just gonna melt. I don't even have to do anything. In fact, I will go ahead and probably. We're going to defend there, just be on the safe side, but yeah, that guy's easy. Easy to kill. Yeah, everything in here can actually get a defense down, which is big, right? So having that is huge, and bringing two physical attackers is definitely the way to go here. Magic users are going to have a hard time. If you have a more magic team than physical, you're going to struggle. Oh yeah, so we want to actually go fire potency here, and the reason for that is because it's going to benefit everybody. Whereas if I do anything else, it's only going to benefit, if I do physical, it's only going to benefit Tifa and Cloud, and we don't want that. So before we fight Gallon Balor up here, we're going to go ahead and use items, just to make sure we get the easiest, best, highest score, fastest score, whatever you want to call it. We're going to use a cottage here. Cottage is the way to go, right? So we're going to pop that. Everybody's nearly at their limit, so that's fine. We're going to go fire potencies on everybody. Simple there. And that's it. We don't really need to do anything else. I mean, I guess I can pop an ATB here or an ether. So, little thing on this fight. When you start this fight, first and foremost, you want to get into defense mode because Gallimblor is going to do a charge move and it's going to hit you for solid damage. So just, there's nothing you can do about it. So just go into defense mode as soon as you get into the fight to mitigate as much damage as possible. So just mash that spot, mash your space bar, whatever it is, however you're playing. That's what you want to do. So mash that. Oh no, I was in defense mode apparently. So did you see that? I was in defense mode. I did not think I was going to be in defense mode. That caught me off guard. That was unfortunate. Yeah, that's not what I was hoping for there. Oh yeah, but he's going to die so fast, it doesn't even matter. Yeah, it doesn't even matter. We're just going to get to our limit and we're in there. I'm going to get everybody to their limit and then he's just dead. Yeah, okay. Well, the damage was so high it didn't matter. Yeah, just Hellfire alone is enough to kill him. So, yeah, this actually wasn't too bad of a very hard, especially if you have some of this good stuff here that I've picked up. Been pretty useful. Pretty good stuff here. And that's it. Easy peasy, man. Wow, he didn't even... the only thing he did was the charge at the beginning, which I just couldn't defend against, unfortunately. But now you can see all the strats that I use, everything like that, especially for these very hard dungeons. That's what you want to do. We've only got one left after this one. We go S plus, good stuff. So honestly, most of the guys in here weren't too bad. I would say if anybody was the most annoying, would probably just be the blue assault scorpion, right? Because he poisons you and he can do an AoE and sweep. And then he also hits everybody. Buffs himself. So that's kind of annoying. But Sahagin could have been more annoying, but I brought what I needed to lower his damage. So that was very helpful as well. So just having that physical attack lowering, you know, that makes a big difference. So we'll pick up all these coins, all these nice things. We cleared that up. So hopefully that helps you guys clear the Lapaina Coast very hard dungeon. You know, and just get an idea of what to bring. You know, kind of see how it goes and my strategies that I use to clear that and get the S plus rank. Thank you for watching the video. If you guys enjoyed it, make sure to hit like and subscribe. You can catch me live every single day on Twitch and YouTube. So be sure to check the links down below in the description for my channels. And I will see you guys on the next video.